Hi students, today we are going to discuss the session on the topic of hydrocarbons. What are generally hydrocarbons? A compounds which contain only carbon and hydrogen alone. In this category, we have lot of homology series, generally CnH2n+2 alkane, like methane, ethane, propane, etc. Then CnH2n alkene, ethene, propene, butene, like that. CnH2n-2 alkyne, acetylene, like that of. Then one more concept is C6H6. Yeah, this is aromatic compound benzene. These are all contains only carbon and hydrogen. So in this particular session, we have to discuss about the preparation properties, the preparation and properties in the sense both physical and as well as chemical properties. Physical and chemical properties. Chemical properties means how they have to react with other compounds, that we have to discuss. Then the major applications of this particular concept. Okay, here the need-based concept is mostly the questions asked from the this particular sessions. Yeah, in the preparation we have Wood's reaction. This is an important name reaction. Based on this we may have a lot of problems. And ozonolysis, again chemical reaction of alkenes, alkynes, both we have to discuss in this. So this is also a major concept. You have to look at these concepts most importantly. Then Markovnikov rule and anti-Markovnikov rule. This is addition reaction happening in alkenes. And Saltzman rule, here this also give the major product based on more substituted alkene. That is, we have to discuss the beta elimination. If there is a beta elimination happening in an unsymmetrical alkane, how it is followed. For that, they are giving Saltzman rule. Then here also, as it catalyzed hydrolysis, like hydroboration, oxymercuration, demercuration are chemical reactions of alkenes. Again, one more chemical test is here, that is most important reagent, Bayer's reagent, that is nothing but dilute alkaline 1% of coal KMnO4. This is only for distinguishing of saturation and unsaturation. If case it is alkene or alkyne compound, means the KMnO4 pink color is decolorized and that gives a brown precipitate. From that brown precipitate we have to confirm the compound is unsaturation, that is the multiple bond is present in that particular compound. Alkanes does not undergo any color change by using Bayer's reagent. Again, catalytic oxidation, we have lot of catalyst. I'll give the list as later. Then reduction reaction is also there. These are important concepts. By they are asking a various catalyst or various reducing agents they are to use, and they may ask a products, what is the major product, like that. Then aromaticity. It is based on Hackel rule. We have to identify the aromatic compound, whether it is aromatic or non-aromatic or anti-aromatic. There is some rules and formulas is followed for that also. Then as the major, you have to study the equations for the preparation of alkane, alkene, alkyne and benzene. And also how to concentrate or go through the properties of physical and chemical, as I said early. Okay. And thus, I have to give only trial for alkane alone. Friends, we have to prepare later of alkene, alkyne and benzene also in the forthcoming videos. Here I am just discuss only alkane. For that I give lot of preparation ways. You also have a concept map, or else you have to prepare like a chart. Okay, from alkenes how we have to prepare. By adding HBr you get a products like that. Then this is also by happening of diborane with the tri-substituted alkyls R3b. There is a catalyst, varying catalyst we have to use. Instead of H2O but acidic media, we can go with AgNO3 or sodium hydroxide. We get a symmetric alkanes like this. From alkynes, we have to general reduction, we can prepare a alkane compounds. Alkyne we are using two times we have to hydrogenate. That is platinum, nickel or palladium as a general metal catalyst. In presence of that we are adding hydrogen, we get a alkane. If platinum and palladium is generally at room temperature, there is no particular temperature. But if you are using nickel as a catalyst, high temperature must be followed. That is also called as a some specific name reaction also. Sabatier-Sandmeyer's reaction. Sanderson reaction is known for nickel used catalyst in this particular hydration. Then from alkyl halide, yeah, we have no some name reactions has come under this category. The general addition is alkyl halide. We have to do with the addition of hydrogen, atomic hydrogen. We are using in zinc and copper couple, we get alkane. Some more varying catalysts, what are we can use instead of this zinc couple? Zinc HCl we can use, zinc acetic acid we can use, red phosphorus plus HA we can use instead of this particular. Then your well-known reaction, Wood's reaction, 2 moles of alkyl halides, we have to take 2 sodium. In presence of dry ether, we get RR, that is here, it is a symmetric alkane. Symmetric alkane. In general is RX plus 2Na plus RX we are using, means by the removal of 2NaX, we get a symmetric alkanes like this. Whatever you have to take in the R group, that we have to get as a symmetrical exactly. Higher member of alkanes we can prepare by this method. Next, from Franklin reagent, RX, we have to get a zinc as a metal. Instead of sodium, here we are using zinc. We get a reagent like Franklin reagent. If it is reacts with alkyl halide, we get again symmetry alkane. Harehouse reaction, lithium as we have to use in the metal, we get a unsymmetrical alkanes we can get. Yeah, from Franklin as well as Wood's reaction, we can get only symmetric. If I want unsymmetrical alkane as a product, I have to go with the Harehouse synthesis, Harehouse reaction. Then by Grignard reagent also we get. By Grignard reagent, if I am adding H2O or alcohol, whatever it may, I get a alkane. Here, the only one hydrogen is added to the respective R group. If I have methyl magnesium halide in presence of alcohol, I get methane as a alkane. Then I get a major product as alkane and byproduct is like this. You may know already, magnesium is a bivalent, like some negative charges is by two negative charges is valence, that magnesium bivalent cation. Then by reduction, I already told, now you get lot of various reactant we have to choose, like substitutions, alcohol we can choose, aldehydes we can go, or ketones we have to go, acid or whatever it may. So from this, the general reducing agent, hydrogen iodide in presence of red phosphorus we are using, we get a various alkanes. What you choose is here, hydroxy group is converted into single H. If it is methyl alcohol, we get methane as a major alkane. Here CHO group is reduced into CH3. Here CO, carbonyl group is reduced into CH2. Here COOH, again C, here also it is converted into alkane. Carbonyl group is converted into methylene. And this is a well-known naming reaction, Clemmensen reduction. You may study in aldehyde ketones chapter. Again, that is zinc amalgamated zinc and corn HCl is a main reagent here. Here also carbonyl group is converted into CH2. Like the same, but the hydrazine, if you are using instead of the zinc amalgamated catalyst, like hydrazine we get, again the same product we get as alkane. The name reaction is changed as Wolff-Kishner reduction. So from carboxylic acid, this is also, you may know, decarboxylation reaction, a very important reaction, decarboxylation reaction, sodium acetate we are having, we get a removal of CO2 in the way of sodium carbonate and we get alkane as like this. Then Golf electrolysis, from this Golf electrolysis we can prepare alkane, alkene, alkyne, lot of the things. Here we have to choose, and by based on this particular substitution we have to get a variety of products. Here electrolysis, you know, dissociation of the compounds. By using anode and cathode, some electrical apparatus we have to use as electrolytic cell, we generally called it anode cathode. Here we are choosing some inert electrodes, and if you are discharged this by passing current, we get alkane as anode side. Okay, here hydrogen is liberated at cathode. These are all the general preparation of alkane alone. Again we have to go with the chemical properties. The major reactions is substitution reaction. Substitution we have to do for halogenation like Cl2, Br2, whatever it may. If in presence of H nu, it is poly substituted. In controlled condition, we get a respective mono halogenated alkanes, alkyl halides. Okay, so halogenation you may know, chlorination, bromination, whatever you may have to do. generally these are all electrophilic substitution naming reactions only. Yeah, electrophile addition is only going to happen here. Nitration, in presence of CaN HNO3 and CaN sulfuric acid, you get a nitroalkane. Again, sulfonation, if you are taking sulfuric acid, you get a sulfonic acid. Okay, here tertiary carbon I'm using. So isomerization, you have to convert from chain isomerism is major part. Our position isomers is possible for alkanes. So N-butane is changed in presence of Lewis acid, either AlCl3 or FeCl3 is a catalyst. In presence of this Lewis acids, we can convert into one particular N-butane is converted into isobutane. This is the example of chain isomerism. Like, we have to get a position and as well as chain by using this Lewis acid. So next is aromatization. A linear compound is converted into an aromatic compound. That is a N-hexane, a linear chain. You may know CH2, CH2, CH2 like that. Six member is there. Six carbon is converted into a ring structure, benzene structure. So here a linear chain is converted into like this, a ring structure. N-actane is converted into toluene. Again, pyrolysis, it is nothing but fission of the higher alkane into smaller alkanes. The pyrolysis is nothing but by using temperature, higher temperatures, we crack the bonds of this alkane. Propane, here thermal decomposition or cracking I have to mention. So propane is at 500 to 700 degrees Celsius converted into propene, ethene and methane. So small other hydrocarbons we obtain from the higher alkane. Then oxidation, friends, here oxidation is having a major three category. One is complete oxidation, that is combustion. This is a general formula. Generally, hydrocarbons contains only carbon and hydrogen. If it is reacts with oxidation or combustion, carbon reacts with oxygen, CO2 is formed. Hydrogen reacts with oxygen, H2O is formed. And also enormous amount of heat and light is liberated. That's why it causes exothermic reaction. So it is a complete oxidation. If it undergo incomplete or partial oxidation, means we get some variation. Carbon monoxide is a byproduct, or else carbon black as a product. So here I just give a partial oxidation as an example here. Then I already told, no, catalytic oxidation is an important concept. Yes, if you are using specific catalyst, we get a specific products like this here. Here in this part I am taking alkanes alone, but if I am using a various catalyst, I get alcohol, aldehyde and acid, like lot of products I got. So here methane is undergo oxidation in presence of red hot copper or iron. At high pressure and temperature I get methanol. Methane is converted into formaldehyde in presence of molybdenum trioxide. Here if I choose n number of whatever it may, or CH3 is converted to CH3 alkane in this methyl group is converted into COOH in presence of manganese acetate. Like tertiary carbon alkane is converted into, here the H is converted into OH in presence of KMnO4, strong oxidizing agent. So these are catalytic depending activities. If you are using various catalysts, you get a various products like this. Then finally, yet now I discuss the important preparation and properties, chemical properties of alkane alone. Like, we have lot of concept maps like that. How to take in your book, here you have to look at, for this is alkane. Up to this they are giving general formula and preparation, physical property and as well as chemical properties, and conformation of alkanes also discussed. This already we discussed in the isomerism concept, I know. So if you have any doubt, you just ask once again, okay? Then you just post questions. Then this is for alkene. Here general formula is CnH2n, and we get preparation. This is also, if you are using Lindlas catalyst, we get cis alkene. If you are using sodium liquid ammonia, if it is the catalyst is varying, then we get a trans alkene as a product. So in this preparation also we have to talk about the stereoisomerism concepts, cis and trans here. So you just be careful in this catalyst. Then dehydrohalogenation, I already told, na, here we have to give more substituted alkene as a major product by based on Seitz of rule. So dehydration of alcohol, this is also, you know, and vicinal dihalides give with the zinc, it gives alkenes. So here also the preparation and chemical properties, and again they have to discuss about the chemical reactions. Here I already told Margonikov rule and as well as anti-Margonikov rules, or crash effect is discussed in this concept. That is nothing but, what does Margonikov rule means? a negative addendum. Here you just look over, HCl is added to this. In generally, addition reaction is happening in alkenes. Yeah, C double bond C means in generally addition reaction is happening. If I am taking HH, this is multiple bond, favor for addition reaction. But this is a symmetry alkene, there is no means. Both H plus and H minus is substituted in one, each one carbon. So your product is, if it is example CH3 or CH3 like CH means, you get varying products. Why? Because the symmetry is disturbed here. Let us give an example like this, CH3, CH double bond CH2. If I am adding HX means, here the negative addendum is, negative group is attached to the carbon which have a less number of hydrogen. This is Margonikov rule. This is Margonikov rule. If I am taking instead of CH3, CH double bond CH2 in presence of HBr and I am using H2O2, hydrogen peroxide I am using as a reagent, here we get a product is differ. Yeah, generally the negative group is goes to attach this less substituted hydrogen, less substituted carbon which contains less number of hydrogen, but here it is somewhat differ. The bromine is attached here, more substituted, and the hydrogen is going like this. The product is CH3 CH2 single bond CH2Br. That is first position, 1-bromo a propane we get. This is the major product instead of 2-bromo propane. If it is Margonikov rule, we get CH3 CHBr CH3 2-bromopropane is a major product. So this is only the difference. Generally HBr, the bromonium ion, only undergo this kind of change. Okay friends, then you may just go through the concepts like this. Again, osinolysis is important concept, I already told you. Know osinolysis, just adding ozone to the double bonded compound. Let we take CH2 double bond CH2. If I am adding O3 molecule, I get a bridge like intermediate like this, CH2 single bond CH. This is an intermediate friends. Then you have to cleave like this in presence of zinc and water, zinc and water, you get the reaction like this. Here one zone, that is 2 moles of formaldehyde, we get a product like this. Okay, plus zinc oxide is removal. The zinc is carrying this oxygen and it leaves as a zinc oxide. Okay, so this is a formaldehyde. Like if what the hydrogen is substituted, we get as this products. Generally we get aldehydes, ketones, and so both aldehyde and ketone is as a major products. So this is also important concept friends. Then again, for alkene, this is for alkene. Alkene also we have general formula CnH2n-2, major preparation, important properties and reactions, here they have to discuss. Then for benzene also, here aromaticity, yeah, I already told Huckel's rule, that is they say 4n plus 2 pi electrons. Huckel said a planar compound, it must be a planar and it must be a conjugation, and 4n plus 2 pi electrons is mandatory. Okay, this is a planar. Conjugation means delocalization. There is an permanent pi shift is always there. If we look at benzene means, there is a shift like this. This is delocalization. So conjugation, planar, and 4n plus 2 pi electrons. And the compound must be having a cyclic nature. Okay, has contained this. So if we have these conditions, then the compound is aromaticity. If 4n pi electrons means that compound is anti-aromatic. The compound is anti-aromatic. If it is not in any one condition is not satisfied, means that is non-aromatic. Again, you just be look over. Generally, benzene is favor for electrophilic substitution reaction, like halogenation, nitration, sulfonation is happening, and Friedel Graf acylation and alkylation is also happening. Then addition reaction, benzene hexachloride we have to get. Then oxidation. And these groups, generally electron releasing groups are favor for ortho and para directing group. If we have benzene and more than one substitution, di substitution or bi substitution happening, means the substituent is based on this. If x is this, y is I am adding, just look at friends. If I have x, If I am adding one more nucleophile like this, means if X is electron releasing group, then this Y is go either ortho or para substituted position. If X is electron withdrawing group, then this Y is go to meta position. What are electron releasing groups? They are listed here. Those who are electron rich is electron releasing groups, and meta directing group, generally we know nitro group, electron withdrawing group, cyanide, aldehyde, like these groups are electron withdrawing groups. If it has as a position here, we get the Y is substituted at meta position. This is ortho, this is meta, this is para position. Okay. Okay friends, now we have to go to the next session as a problem discussion.